You're about to listen to the unadulterated word of God from Reverend David Kakati.
Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 19 and 20.
Odifu Jeremiah homaniti ba kunti chemu dun kronko pem edionu.
He said they shall fight against you.
Wase wano ube kondiye.
You can sit down for 1 minute. They shall fight against you.
Wase wano ube kon.
But they shall not overcome you.
Suwo tumi ndi usuda.
Because I am with you.
Esa se minya meme na mo ho.
To deliver you.
Se be chemu.
Say it the Lord.
Sine nyankopon sini.
Say in the name of Jesus
Christ,
they shall not overcome me. Because what you cannot declare, you don't deserve it. And what you cannot say, you cannot see it. So say it well. Say, I declare in the name of Jesus, they cannot overcome me. Say the forces. Say the creatures. Say the powers. Fighting against me. In the marriage. In the family. In the industry. In my business. I declare, they shall not prevail. In the name of Jesus. Say, oh Lord, arise.
Sorry.
And scatter all of them. Say, oh Lord, arise.
Sorry.
And scatter all of them. In the name of Jesus. Say, I declare, any spirit that is fighting me, any creature that is fighting me, oh Lord, arise.
Sorry.
And scatter them. Oh Lord, arise.
Sorry.
And scatter them. In the name of Jesus. You shall prevail in the midst of the battles. In the name of Jesus Christ. You shall prevail in the midst of the storms. In the name of Jesus Christ. You shall prevail in the midst of the oppositions. In the mighty name of Jesus. Say, I declare, any power that is fighting me, they are terminated. They are terminated. In the name of Jesus, I declare, battles against me, oppositions against me, limitations against me, your time is up. Expire. In the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus was in the grave, but he was still the Lord. I said Jesus was in the grave, but he was still the Lord. That is why we have been singing a song that says that even in the grave, he is Lord. Even in the grave, he is Lord. So he was in the grave. It looks like he has gone down. It looks like the enemy has finished him. It looks like the enemy has overcome him. But he didn't change his status. He didn't change his status. He didn't change his level. He didn't change who he was. I want you to understand that when you look at your situation, it may look like you are down. It looks like the enemy has succeeded. It looks like the enemy has overcome you. But I want you to know, your level shall not come down. Your greatness shall not come down. Your
favor shall not come down. Your victory shall not come down. In the name of Jesus. You may not have one CD in your pocket, but by the Spirit of the Lord, you are still on top. You may not have food on your table, but by the Spirit of God, you are still on top. You may be owing somebody, but by the Spirit of the Lord, you are still on top. Everything is turning against you, but by the Spirit of God, you are on top. I declare in the name of Jesus that the storm you are going through shall expire. The battle you are going through shall expire. The opposition you are going through shall expire. But as for you, you shall survive. As for you, you shall prevail. As for you, you shall have a testimony. As for you, you shall come out greater and better and taller. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive that grace over your life. Receive that grace over your life. In the name of Jesus, say, oh Lord, arise and let the battles expire. Say, oh Lord, arise and let the battles expire. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Sit down. I want you to understand. I've not started the real preaching. I'm just introducing you.
These are
some things the Lord is dropping into my spirit. Look, I want you to understand that Daniel was in the lion's den. But God has not deserted him. Human beings have written him off. Human beings are saying ye wieno. Human beings are saying ye nyano. Human beings are saying ye nyano. Human beings are saying that ye wie ya ba. So he was in the lion's den, but God was with him. Don't judge yourself by what you are going through. I said, don't judge yourself by what you are going through, but judge yourself by the invisible God that is standing by your side, and that is backing you despite what you are going through. And so they were jubilating, and so they were enjoying themselves. We have finished Daniel. He has been causing problems for us. He was a thorn in our flesh. Now he's in the lion's den. We have finished him. But they didn't know that their celebration will be cut short. They didn't know that their jubilation will expire. Before they realize, Daniel was out of the lion's den. I want you to know that you come out of the situation. By the Spirit of the Lord, you come out of the situation. That negative situation, you come out of it. In the mighty name of Jesus. And your enemies are going to laugh on the wrong side of their cheek. In the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for you today that any evil spirit, any evil creator that is rejoicing against you, I cut short their rejoicing. I cut short their rejoicing. In the mighty name of Jesus, say, I declare, I am out of the limitation. Say, I am out of the trap of the enemy. Say, I am out of every entanglement. In the mighty name of Jesus, the word of the Lord said, if God is for you, who can be against you? He said, in the midst of all this, you are more than a conqueror. You are more than a conqueror. Receive the grace of the Lord over your life. I said, receive the grace of the Lord over your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Sit down. If you cannot praise God, it means you are complaining. And those who complain shall be grounded. If you cannot say thank you to God, you cannot say thank you to God. You cannot say thank you to God. It means you are complaining. It means you are grumbling. And those who grumble shall be grounded. They will be stagnated. because God will desert them, because God will not enjoy their company. But those who celebrate God, and they can still thank God, God enjoys their company. Praise the Lord. Say, I am more than a conqueror. Say, my enemy, don't rejoice over me, because if I fall down, I shall rise again. And if I am in the darkness, the Lord shall be my light, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
One of the things you have to realize, lift your hand to the Lord. Say, Holy Ghost, save my soul. Say, Holy Ghost, transform my life. Open my eyes. Stir my faith. Give me understanding. Let wonders happen in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. There must be no question about your salvation. There must be no dispute about your salvation. That you don't know whether you go to heaven or not. You must know. You must know. I said you must know,
Mr. Etise,
what it takes to secure a place in heaven. Your place in heaven is not determined and decided by human beings. It's not determined by the opinions of human beings. It's determined by the standards of God. And you must know it and apply yourself to it. Because human beings will judge you. Human beings will condemn you. Once you don't please them, once you don't do what they want, they will condemn you and they will judge you. And they will cut you off from God and make you feel that you are nothing. So you must know what it takes for you to be saved. You must know what it takes to have eternal place with God. And the word of God has painted it very clearly to us. And I'll show you one of them today, so that you will be confident in God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So in Acts chapter 4 verse 10. You must always hold your Bible, either in a printed form or on your phone or on your tablet. You must always have your Bible.
So that your
link with God will not be determined by the speed or the lateness of somebody. And refer to it, so that the day that the computer decides to misbehave, you still have the word. There are some of us, if the computer guy decides to get angry and he decides not to project the scriptures, we are finished. We don't have scripture again. So you must have your Bible, either on paper or on your phone or your tablet. You can always refer to it. So he said, be it known to you all and to all the people of
Israel
that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him, is this man standing here before you whole. It is by him
Jesus Christ, the one that was crucified and didn't remain in the grave, but was raised from the dead. It is by him. It is by him that this man is whole. It is by him that this man is complete. It is by him that this man is perfect. It is by him that this man is faultless. It is by him that this man is guiltless. Say by him. Say by him. Say by him.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Say by Jesus Christ. I am whole. Say by Jesus Christ. I am whole. Say by Jesus Christ. I am clean. Say by Jesus Christ. I am guiltless. Say by Jesus Christ. I am faultless. Say by Jesus Christ. I am perfect. Say by Jesus Christ. I am complete. Say I am complete. Say I am complete.
So Jesus has completed you. He has polished you. He has finished you. So you must know. You must know what qualifies you in the sight of God. You must know. Otherwise, human beings will put you in bondage by their corrupted standards. God is the standard. And the word of God is the standard. Say by him. Say it again. Say by him.
That's
yes. So by his name. By his name. By his blood. By his grace. By his sacrifice on the cross. And by his word. By him. By him. Now when you go to verse 12, he said, neither is there salvation in any other. After he told them that by Christ Jesus you are saved, he said, if you think that there is another name, if you think that there is another religion somewhere that you can get salvation, he said, neither is there salvation in any other. For there is no other name under heaven. Under heaven. Given among men. By which we must be saved. There is no other anywhere. Allow them to mention the names. There is no other name anywhere. This is the only name. Jesus Christ. Say it well. Say Jesus Christ.
Say Jesus Christ.
Say Jesus Christ.
Say Jesus Christ.
Say I am secured.
By Jesus Christ.
Say I am secured.
Say
by Jesus Christ.
Say Jesus Christ.
Angels salute that name.
Above.
That's what the Bible says. Angels salute that name. Once you mention that name, angels will respect you. It's like in Ghana here, when you mention the name of the president, people must respect you. When you come with the name of the president, they must respect you. When you come with the complimentary card of the president, you enter an office. And then you want something from the boss in the office,
baby, your in
and you give him complimentary card of the president.
Now the boss
will treat you special.
He will treat you special.
So when you use the name of Jesus Christ, demons will treat you special. Evil spirits will treat you special. Heaven will treat you special. Even hell will treat you special. There is no other. I said there is no other. So I want to encourage you to be confident. In the name that we are carrying. Say no shaky. Say no shaky. The name that we are carrying.
So
no shaky. Be confident. Amen.
Amen.
There is none other given amongst men whereby we must, if you must be saved, there is no other name except the name of Jesus Christ.
Say, "Eye bang, Antia, dimbi ani bebi ebiyo, dimbi ani bebi ebiyo."
Praise God.
Tuasasi aye tisui.
Now I want to share with you,
say,
how to be fruitful and how to enjoy harvest in life.
Kwa befasu ya obedore, na wenyi ocha bibiri, odore bibiri, ewa brabum.
Because there are things you must do.
And
there are things God must do. When everything depends on God, you are becoming irresponsible. There are things God must do. And there are things you must do for what God is doing for you to manifest. So if you don't do what you must do, what God is doing for you shall not manifest. And you will be disappointed. And you'll be frustrated. When somebody gets to the level where he says that God has disappointed him.
So be do some pempensuno say, ah,
when somebody gets to the level,
do some pempensuno
where he says, I've worshipped God, I didn't see anything. When somebody gets to the level,
be do some pempensuno
where he begins to say that this is what the word of God says, but it has not been fulfilled in my life. It means that that person has been an irresponsible Christian.
So
what he was supposed to do, he didn't do it. So when people begin to speak like that, I have gone to church. He should let you know that person was an irresponsible
churchgoer.
That person was an irresponsible Christian.
No, your Christian is asudie pianoso.
Because if you have to go to the toilet, you carry yourself to the toilet. God does not carry you to the toilet. That means in life you have a role to play.
The
food
have
been prepared and the table have been laid, but you have to open your mouth. Even if somebody is spoon feeding you, you must open your mouth before the food can enter. Otherwise, you will die. So there is always a responsibility on our part. So if you want to excel in God, if you want to excel in life, the question you have to be asking is that, what must I do? To see changes, to see progress, to move forward, what must I do? As I am walking with God, I know that God, as for him, he is faithful. As for him, he will not fail. As for him, he will not disappoint me. So what am I supposed to do to connect with God so that what belongs to me in God shall manifest? Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So nobody should open his mouth and say, "Masum nyamia mehushi." It is a pronouncement of total irresponsibility. Praise God. What must I do?
Then they say me.
What must I do?
Then they say me.
Until you start adding value and providing services and meeting needs,
you are not useful.
Say what they a boar.
Until you start adding value, providing services and meeting needs, you will not be fruitful. So the watcher seller is meeting some needs and providing service. So
you will get money.
The ice water seller is meeting some needs. People are thirsty, and so the ice water seller is meeting needs, providing a service.
So the
fitter or the mechanic is providing a service. He is meeting needs.
Intuition.
He is adding value to people's life, so that their car can move, so he will get money. So if in your life you are not meeting needs, you are not providing services, you are not adding value to anybody's life, you are barren, and you are useless. And nothing will come to you. Am I communicating to somebody? So as a pastor, when you listen to me, it must add value to you. When you listen to me, it must enhance you. If you listen to me, it must better you. Your understanding must get deeper. Your knowledge level must be enhanced. Your spirituality must get better. Your relationship with God must grow better. As a pastor, that means I'm adding value to you. So anytime you come to church, I must speak something that will add value to you. That is when your level will change. So church is not a place where we while away time.
No,
it is a place where value is added. Am I communicating to somebody at all? Yes. People have spiritual problem. When they come to church, it is addressed. We are meeting needs. Battles are confronting people when they come to church. We deal with it.
And they pray to a man for Moba Obaha.
Arrows are flying in the family and in the workplace.
Yes.
When you come to church, we release scriptures and prayer topics.
Yes.
That will expire those arrows. That will secure you. So we are adding value and we are meeting needs. Am I communicating to somebody at all? Yes. So when you go to a church and then you don't learn anything, there's nothing that is said to draw you closer to God, nothing strengthens you in God, nothing enhances your level and understanding, you have wasted your time. Am I communicating to somebody? You have wasted your time.
That is what say Wumri.
That's why a pastor must research. A pastor must learn. A pastor must study.
Nyame sofo so suya de no shish oye shishimu.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So tell yourself from today.
The catcher wants a fin neko.
I'll add value.
I'll
provide services.
I will meet needs.
Wherever you are working, how much value are you adding? How much value are you adding to the work? Because if you are not adding value to the place where you are employed, you are useless there. And when they want to dismiss people, you will be among the first people they will dismiss. But when you are adding value to the work, you are enhancing the work, you are helping
you are helping the profit of your boss to rise. You are helping the customers to increase. Your boss knows that there is value on you. But when customers come, you talk to the customers rough, and they go and they don't come in again. You are not adding value to the company. So, they will dismiss you. So, that which makes you useful, that will cause people to maintain you and keep you. Is the value you are adding. So, there are people who will dress. And they'll go and sit in an office. And they'll just be chatting. They'll just be chatting. And they'll be reading newspapers. And they'll be working lotto. When the actual work, why they have been employed there? They are not doing it. And when customers come, they frustrate the customers. So if the work is going down, why would they get money to pay you and to keep you? So when we are talking about fruitfulness and harvest, this is the basis. Amen. And because they have gone to the workplace and they are not adding value, even though they are paying them, the pay is not amounting to anything. It is expiring because they didn't work for it. So nothing good is coming out of their lives. So if I am under Bishop Charles Ejinasari, I must be useful to him. I must not become a problem to him. I must not become a burden to him. I must solve problems for him. I must be able to read my bishop and begin to figure out what he's looking for. Without he telling me, I organize and I make sure that thing is taken care of. Then he will look at me. He will say, you are not just carrying an empty title. Posting yourself with your title. But you are really, you have been able to figure out my vision. And you are meeting it. That is value. If you want to be promoted at your workplace, if you want them to increase your salary, these are some of the things. Amen. Let me show you two simple things. Let me just show you two of them. In the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 6, Timothy, whom I told you, Timothy, did you mention? He said, "The husbandman that laboreth must be first partaker of the fruits." Ochi ase okuafuna odo efuono etse onu no di kai di abenibi. The husbandman that laboreth. Okuafuno aoye jumano. Not the husbandman that fold his hands. Enye okuafua. Not the husbandman that is standing idle. Not the husbandman that does not involve himself. He said the husbandman that labors. So you must labor.
And
you are not laboring until you are adding value, you are meeting needs, and you are providing services.
Amen.
Yes. You are not laboring until you are meeting needs. They say come and be an MC. And then the MC you are doing is like ice water MC. It is not blessing anybody. You are not laboring. You are wasting time.
What's the MC?
Come and do MC. No research.
come and do MC. No research.
Okay, one go yen jishe mu kura anko she say MC kura ba de na so ka obegina ho sen. One go man go yen jishe.
No scripture.
One go yen
scripture.
Jo se mia.
Then you come and stand here. Give the Lord a shout. Clap your hands to the Lord. What are you saying? What are you saying?
Yeah, na oka.
That will better me. What are you saying? The things that I am going through that I came here. I'm going through something in the marriage. I'm going through something in the office. I'm going through something in the office. And then you come and stand here. Give the Lord a shout. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do it better to the Lord. Do it better to the Lord.
Okay.
After we have given the Lord a shout, what have you given to us that we are taking home?
And I be saying,
what have you given to us that we are taking?
Well, Sam, amen, amen.
So physically, you must add value. Spiritual things to you must add value. I preach a certain message in Amanfro. After the message, a certain guy came to me. He said, this message has changed my life. He said, we have been working for a certain Chinese company. And when we gather as workers, we would just be criticizing the Chinese. Finding fault with them. But after I've listened to you, I will not criticize my Chinese boss again. Now, when I go, I'll make sure I do the work well. So the message I preach has brought a positive change in his life.
Yes. That is
value. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Then another person came to my office. And he came to kneel down. He said, when I go back, I'm going to beg my pastor. He wasn't a member of the church. Somebody invited him. He visited. He said, he was shedding tears. He said, I have offended my pastor. Because of your message, I have seen it. When I go back, I am going to apologize to my pastor. So that message has brought about restoration of a destroyed relationship. It is the one who labors. That must do a partaker of the fruit. It is the one who labors. Not the one who is just present. No. Not the one who is just a part of the team. No. Not the one who is just a part of the group. No. Not the one who is occupying some position. No. It is the one who is working. That can partake of the results. That shall partake of the fruits. That shall partake of the benefit that comes. So some people are employed. They say, they have employed us, but they are not paying us well. Are you laboring? He said, what qualifies you to partake of the result and the profit?
It's the labor.
So I must labor. That's why I must not come to church late as a pastor. No.
I must labor.
Yes. This work is higher than the bank work. This work is higher than the bank work because it has eternal value. The bank work cannot cross the grave just yet. This one is superior.
We was so.
So if bankers go to work early, they leave the house 5 a.m. They go to work early.
Those who
are just doing earthly things, common things,
they go to work early.
And when they go to work, they don't sit on phone and be chatting with people. Then the work of God, which is higher and superior to all other work, which brings salvation and eternity to people. We don't joke with it.
We don't joke with it.
We
don't joke with it. Because it determines your eternal residence. It determines your eternal abode. So we don't joke with it.
Man,
am I communicating to somebody?
Yes.
Wednesday, I am here. I'm here very early.
Bantam.
Yes. Friday, I am here very early.
Fiada me waha.
And anybody that shall be close to me,
ubi obe beme no,
must respect God and the things of God.
Ese ubu nyami juma, ene ne niyama.
All the people you see them doing something.
Wow, umuso biya nyami juma no.
It's because they have value for God.
Then say ubu nyami.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because when rain is falling, the banker does not sit in the house. He
doesn't
sit in the house.
Yes.
Yes. The secretary in the bank does not sit in the house. The cleaner in the bank does not sit in the house. Why should I sit in the house? Because rain wants to fall. That is why people go to church, they don't get anything.
Yes.
The banker knows that when he goes, when he misses that, when he doesn't go to work, he can lose something. He knows. The banker knows.
He
can lose something.
Yes. Yes.
So, he will go. Even if the rain is falling, he will go. But the one who is going to the church, a prayer leader in the church, a singer in the church, an usher in the church, who is ministering to the people of God,
will
say because of traffic, I'll use it as excuse. And the demons will be whispering into his head.
Use it as excuse.
So if I don't do it for God,
I'll
not lose anything. That is the thinking. Yes. That is why when they come also, they don't get anything. Because in their thinking, if I don't go, I will not lose anything. So God has also accepted it. So when you come, he's also watching you like that. But when you value the covenant between you and God, the relationship between you and God, that is when you receive things. Am I communicating to somebody at all? You must see fruits in your life. You must see results in your life. You must see profits in your life. You must see benefits in your life. You must not serve God and your life will sink. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
That's the first thing. You must labor.
So we hear you, my day.
So people will be in a company, then others are flourishing in the company, but some are not flourishing. Yet they have been there for years. They have been there for a long time. But they are not flourishing.
They are complaining
and they are murmuring. It is the labor. He said it is those who labor that they will partake of the enjoyment. They will partake of the blessing. They will partake of the fruits. They will partake.
Those who labor.
Those who labor. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
When people are given assignment to do for God,
they
are not interested in doing the assignment for God. They are thinking of what they can collect.
But they
don't know that there is a law that says that you have to invest something before something can come.
Say
Holy Ghost, anoint me to labor spiritually and physically. Say Holy Ghost, anoint me to labor spiritually and physically. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I've been telling people,
Anywhere I am, the work of God must not suffer.
Anywhere I am.
It means if I am there and the work of God is suffering, it means I am valueless in the sight of God. I am valueless.
What?
When I go there and I see that something is lacking in the house of God, I will fix it. I will fix it. And now I'll look for others who are interested in the welfare of the things of God. I will say, come. Come.
Bra.
Come,
also bra.
Let's fix it.
Amen.
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 Yes. So if you are committed to God, when you come to church, you also look for others who are interested in the things of God. You invite them. Let's go and pray. Let's go and pray. Let's go and pray. Monday you come here, people are praying. Tuesday you come here, people are praying. Nobody has told them. They themselves. They are praying. They are catching the spirit. The fire.
Yeah, bomb fire, man.
You catch the fire in the name of Jesus Christ. You catch the spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Number two.
Let us me.
These are the only two things I'll be sharing today. Be connected to God. Be connected to God. If you want to be fruitful and get a harvest, John chapter 15 verse
2.
Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, the Lord will take away. And every branch in me that bear fruits, the Lord will purge it, that it may bring forth more fruits. So if you don't produce fruits, fruit means that you are producing after your own kind. If you love God, you produce others who love God. If you are prayerful, you produce others who are prayerful. That is fruits. If you are really committed to God, you produce others who are committed to God. You don't display actions that discourage others who want to be committed to God. So he said, if you don't bear fruit, God will take you away. So many people, that's how come many people are taken away from the things of God.
Because
they go to the time where they were not producing fruits.
As I said,
they thought they have arrived. So God himself will take them away. If you don't bear fruit, God will cut you off. God will do away with you. Very soon. God will replace you. Before you realize, somebody who can do it better than you, God has found a way of bringing the person. So everything that I do it to my best. If I have to lead prayer, there are times I pray throughout the night. If I have to lead prayer on Tuesday at the dome, yes,
yes. Yes.
Pray throughout the night. Getting the right scriptures. Getting the right prayer topics. Praying about it. So that somebody will be loosed. Somebody will be liberated. Somebody will be raised. As I need them to pray. We call it investment. You are investing into the thing. Whether your enemies like it or not, God will bless you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
God will bless you. Yes, God will bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So
If you don't bear fruits, you have not added anything to the things of God, to the work of God. You have not brought any improvement. God will eliminate you. Before you realize something has happened and you are being expelled, God himself will pull you out. You thought it was something that happened, they pull you out. It is God that used that thing to pull you out. Before you realize your name is deleted, you are discarded and you have been detached. But he said, the one who is producing fruit, the one who is enhancing my work, the one who is adding value to it, the one who is showing commitment and investing into it, he said, I'll purge that person. I'll forgive that person. I'll wash that person. I'll cleanse it. I will endorse the person. I will insert the person.
Yes,
I will insert him. The one who is bearing fruits. Adding value. Yes. Before others will come, he has come already. He's leading the intercession. He's bearing fruits. I told you, when I was at the headquarters, I was praying that the pastors who lead prayer, they shouldn't come. So when it is 30 minutes to the time, as a young guy, I'll be standing there. I'll be marking time. I wasn't a pastor by then. Let them be late. When it is 1 minute to the time, I'll go and take them. I don't need encouragement from anybody to serve God. The Holy Ghost himself is encouraging me. The Holy Ghost himself is moving me. May you receive that anointing in the name of Jesus. I said, may you receive that anointing in the name of Jesus. It is very easy to know people who have the anointing of the Holy Ghost.
I'm telling you, people
who have the anointing of the Holy Ghost, when they are coming to church, they are in a hurry. When they are late, they are in a hurry. You see them driving the car. They don't want to be late. Today, this man was late. And he was driving. He's in a hurry to come because he's late. He's anointed. I saw wisdom when he's coming. By 7 a.m. he's coming. He is, because it is 5 minutes past 7. He's rushing. It is an anointing on the person that makes the person
better.
The one who doesn't carry the anointing. That is how he's working. When he gets here, cry. He will not hurry up to enter. He doesn't have anointing. The spirit has been silenced. The Holy Ghost is silenced in his life. But the one that the fire of God is upon, that anointing of God is upon him,
he's
in a hurry. It's very easy to know people who are anointed. Who carry the fire? By the grace of God, I am in charge of the breakthrough service in the dome. The service starts at 11, but I must be there by 9. The service starts at 11. And by 9, I pray with some pastors from 9 to 11 for the service.
Na me ni asofu bia shempa e bona se no nkuru kopem nondu ansana
That one, Bishop didn't ask me to do that.
And you also found no catch him.
But he has given me a work to do.
You
must invest in the work. I must invest in the work. And he said, as long as the heaven and the earth lives, every seed you sow, there shall be a harvest. I'm investing in my father's work. There is a harvest for
me.
If some few years from now, you hear that I'm making impact in the whole of the nation and outside the nation, it came from a seed. The oil on his life shall work upon him. It is a seed. He just gave me the way. He said, handle the breakthrough service. Handle it. Organize it. Make sure it is working well. So I took initiative. 2 hours of prayer. Let's invest it in it. Yes. If I have to take my children to school, and I realize they are late, I'll tell my wife, get a taxi, take them to school. I leave the
children.
We spend extra money for taxi to go.
So that
I can take good care of my father's assignment. You can't bring me down. Because I am sowing some seeds. And the unbreakable law of God says that the seed must produce. One day Bishop came to the church.
And
he was asking people, whose car is that? He comes to church early. Anytime he got to the church, he saw that car parking.
So he said,
anytime I come around, this car is here before. And they told him it is Apostle David's car.
David Nishini.
He shook his head. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So we have a responsibility.
Yewo asudi.
Amen.
Amen.
If you bear fruits,
osu aba,
God will flourish you.
Nyame bema wa atore.
If you bear fruits,
osu aba,
God will enlarge you.
Nyame bema wa tre.
No seed germinates the following day. No. Doesn't germinate the following day. It takes time for the seed to
grow.
It takes time for it to grow. It takes time for it to flourish. Why should I walk with God for 10 years and nothing is showing in my life? Should I be going to church for 10 years, 15 years? Nothing is showing in my life. It's because the part I needed to play in my work with God, I didn't play it. You must vow and swear to yourself. I must not serve God and become a disgrace. I must not serve God and become a reproach. And nobody ever served God in the Bible, and the person regretted. If you serve God,
will
bring you out of the fire. If you serve God,
will
bring you out of the lion's den. If you serve God,
will
bring you out of the prison. God will never desert you. God will never disappoint you. God will never leave you on your own. I prophesy over your life. The seed you have sown, the investment you have made, may the Lord watch over it. And may the Lord produce for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to Jesus. No farmer prays for his seed to germinate. They don't pray. When they sow, they know that they know.
They know.
If you put the cassava stick in the soil, you know. Put the maize in the soil, you know.
There is an unbreakable law. Demons cannot stop it.
Demons.
And if demons try to stop it, your prayers and your fasting, the Holy Ghost anointing will clear them. If you are not bearing fruit, the enemy will sentence you, the enemy will dirty you, the enemy will condemn you if you are not bearing fruit.
So what no quality so one so about bonsam be man wire poto bonsam do betu efiase.
If you are not bearing fruit,
how about so so one so about
the enemy will imprison you and you will be confined.
Mr. Odo betu efiase obose ogina faako uyo Christo ni pa so na efiase.
John 15 verse 4.
He obo humano etidunum chichemu nine no.
Said abide in me.
O say tremi mu
and I in you.
Na me ewo mu.
As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself.
Then I krabata no ontumi nso aba ono ano ho no.
Except you abide in me.
Jira o tremi mu.
You cannot bear fruit.
Ontumi nso aba.
Amen.
Amen.
Let me read it again.
Amen. Kind of you.
Abide in me.
Also, tina mi mu.
And I in you.
Na me tina umu.
As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself,
sene diam kurabata no entumi nso aba nenkasa entumi nso aba.
Except it abides in the plant.
Tina ewo dia no hu ansene entumi nso aba no.
No more can you bear fruits.
Obie entumi nso aba.
Except they abide in me.
Tina umi mu.
People are disconnected from God. That is why they continue going to church and there is no fruits.
Yes.
There is no fruit. Jesus said, reside in me, stay in me.
Christ said, tina mi mu.
Abide in me.
Tina mi mu.
Make sure that you are settled in me.
Shese, uti mi mu.
Then you can bear fruit.
Oho na betuma swaba.
Many people have migrated from God.
Oh, bebre, ayotuka kena umetu efinya mi mu.
Many people have shunned God. They are even resisting God.
Wangu bebre apa nyame na wosi nyame kwai.
They have departed from God.
Wangu efinya mi nchini.
So there is no fruit to sow.
Ya bebiye nuo awo de bechire.
He said, persevere in me, persist in me.
Ase tokosu ewo mi nyame mu.
Continue in me.
Tokosu ewo mi mu.
Make sure that 5 years from now when I come, you are still prevailing in me.
Na mi wo se mfie num efesambre mi nyame meba no na wo da so temi mu.
Then you will bear fruits.
Oho na bo so beso aba.
Amen.
Amen.
To abide with God.
So betine nyame mu.
To abide in God.
So betine nyame mu no.
Make sure that you are really associated with him.
Ese wo do wo hye nyame mu.
Make sure that you are united with him.
Wo ni nyame yonkofa ne mu aden.
Means that you have been bracketed into the same bracket with God.
Ese wo ni nyame ankasa ya mo hye dan ba ko mu.
There is an affiliation between you and God.
Wo ni nyame mu wo twaka.
That is what produces fruits.
Ene so aba.
Amen. The reason why many people are ashamed of their Christianity. They are ashamed of their Christianity. They cannot be proud and say, I am a Christian.
Because
people will insult him.
Because
he doesn't have any fruits. There is no results. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Yes. I pray for you today. Nothing will disconnect you from God. Nothing will cut you off from God. Nothing will disunite you from God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The love that you had for God from the beginning. I pray for you that love shall get stronger and stronger. I pray for you that love shall get stronger and stronger. In the name of Jesus Christ. There are many Christians when they look at their life. They themselves, they are feeling pity for themselves. Because they know how they have gone down in the spirit. They know. They can see.
They can see how they have gone down. So they are feeling pity for themselves. But there is a good news for you. That fire can come back. That fire can come back. I said that fire can come back. When one candle is out and another candle has light, just take the one that has light and then put it on the one which has no light.
Yes.
Yes. And if the gas burner one has gone down and there is one that has fire, you just take the matches, put it on the one that has fire, you bring it back here, and the fire has gone.
So gas and then so there no betumi aso ne aka no.
So the fire is transferable.
Oja e betumi aso dia ko baby.
The fire is transferable.
Itu ko yobi obi muchia oja na dia baby muchia me ya kweda to ne der bra.
Lift your hands to the Lord.
Ma onsa so.
Declare it.